Eric back at the Naturopath. Thanks for coming back to my channel. Before we jump into this video, don't forget, at the end of the video, you can download some free resources that I've created just for you. The Candida Diet and Cleanse Starter Guide, the Ultimate Candida Shopping List, the Diet Shopping List, and also the Candida Symptom Tracker, which you're going to find very useful. So these are all for free. So at the end of the video, just jump into yeastinfection.org/goodies and you can download these things at no charge at all. If you have any questions, remember you can always ask those and either I can get back to you or the team. So thanks for tuning in and we'll catch up with you at the end of the video. Eric back of the Naturopath. Thanks for coming back. We're still talking, we're still doing questions, and I'm still in New Zealand. I'd love to travel, but it's problematic at the moment, as a lot of people realize. So let's talk about some reasons why people crave sugar. So these are five good reasons or basic reasons, but there could be 50. But these are five from some, what I gather, are quite common reasons why someone like you out there, or someone like me, or whoever, craves sugar or wants sweet food. So let's talk about those five things now. Some kind person might come along as a comment and put, it's so many seconds, this topic, it's so many. I've had a few people do that, that's pretty cool. So they break that down in the comment section. First one, you didn't eat enough. You did not eat enough food. You're in a hurry. You snacked, you grabbed something. Either that or you grab the wrong kind of sugar. Now, many people believe that artificial sweeteners are actually okay because they got zero calories. But calories are what your body turns to energy, okay? Now, you've got to be careful here because artificial sugars can make you falsely believe that you've had a sugar hit, but then you'll crash very quickly wanting another sugar hit. So artificial sugars are not really a good substitute for sugar at all. The other key thing is you just didn't eat enough food. You skipped breakfast or you had a small breakfast. So you're running on empty. You're going on a long trip. You're driving across America, but you've only half filled the gas tank. Well, how can you expect to get anywhere with a gas tank half empty? You can't. As I've written here, calories are the only thing that provides real energy. So consistently eating whole foods, foods that have got proteins in them and fats and carbs in a reasonable balance, is going to give you energy and pull you through. It's like filling up the gas tank. If you're skimping on eating, you're skimping on energy production, all right? So you need to eat. Now you don't need to eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner consistently like many people do, but you need to work out how much food and when to eat suitable for your situation, especially if you're a shift worker. Yeah, you know, I mean, I don't know what kind of job you guys have got out there, but you have to eat and sleep accordingly to how you work. Number two, you picked up a bad habit. Haven't we all picked up bad habits at times? Lots of people have. Some people spend way too much time in front of TV. Some people do all sorts of crazy things. Some people spit all their lives. They have bad habits like that. Other people have chocky bars. You know, they'll have a can of Red Bull, or they'll have a chocolate bar or a yum yum bar, as I call them, you know, at 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon. This is quite common. People go to vending machine, they get a chocky bar out. So this is not a good habit to get into. A good way to break this habit in the afternoon is to have something sweet, but in the form of a tea. I've got a whole range of herbal teas. Licorice tea is a good one, for example. There could be apple, cinnamon, ginger. There are so many tasty infusions you can get now. You can put a little bit of lemon juice in there if you want, or you can put a tiny bit of honey in there, which will give you extra bit of sweetening on top of that herbal tea. But a herbal tea is a good way often to break that bad habit of wanting that sweet thing in the afternoon. But the question is, why do you want that sweet thing around 2-3 o'clock? Now we'll talk about that later on, so hang around. So if you ate more protein in the earlier part of the day, chances are you wouldn't really want the yum yum bar, would you? Third one, eating far too much carbs and not enough protein or fat. This is a mistake I've seen several people make over the years. Many patients I've had were telling me they're tired in the afternoon or falling asleep after a meal. But when I examined the meal, it was a lot of pasta, or it was a lot of bread, or it was a lot of rice, but it wasn't a lot of other stuff there. When you eat a heavy starchy meal, like a bowl of pasta, or three or four slices of bread with a little bit of peanut butter on it, you are setting yourself up for a craving, basically. So when you eat carbs, you know your blood sugar goes up, but it will start coming down, and it will start going up and coming down. So you're going to create this wave-like effect of fatigue, energy. We call this hyperglycemia, low blood sugar, and it's not really a good idea. It's a little bit like driving your car and then slamming the brakes and then accelerating and then braking and then slamming the brakes. You're going to wear that mechanism out, like a lot of young guys do, you know, road racing boys, you know. People do this to their pancreas. They do this to their digestive glands. They just, you know, they just race them, basically. Too much carb. Too much carb in the form of fries, in the form of Coca-Cola, these sorts of things. So having a large bowl of pasta is no different from having a large bowl of sugar, basically, right? It's just the reaction time may be a little bit different. So what are you going to do if you love carbs, like pasta, for example? Well, you add some meat to it. You add some olive oil, some fat to it, but you reduce the amount of carb in proportion to the other foods you're eating. So instead of a Pavarotti-sized plate of pasta, okay, you have a small serving. So portion size is the key one, a smaller amount of pasta, a lot more veggies, like tomatoes maybe, or onions or other veggies. You put like zucchinis, courgettes could go in there. And then some meat or some legumes, some beans or some chickpeas or whatever you want to put in there additionally. But that needs to be higher than the pasta, if you get my drift, right? So this is the intelligent approach, less carb. So when you eat too much starch, you'll really notice that drowsiness, that fatigue. I couldn't believe it. A few years ago, they had a campaign in New Zealand to get people to pull over and stop and to rest, you know, on long trips. And they were giving them chalky bars. Should have given them a T-bone steak. That's what they should have been given, and a glass of water. Number four, you ate a lot of really spicy food or a lot of really salty food. I've often found when people eat a lot of these kind of foods, they get a mouthfeel. Okay, they like the stimulation, but then after they want something sweet. In my Candida book, I wrote often that when people crave sweet after a meal, it's because the yeasts are calling your name. They are. They want feeding. Your gut needs feeding, bacteria need feeding, yeast need feeding. So the more yeast you've got, sometimes the stronger the sugar cravings can be. Really strong when you've got a bad gut problem. You know? But don't blame it on the gut, because the bacteria in the gut are pulling the strings, these strings up here. So the gut bacteria control a lot of our thoughts, a lot of our desires, a lot of our drives. So this is why they call this the second brain. Okay. So when you're dining out on some foods and there's a lot of sodium in it, it could precipitate or push you into a state where you want something sweet thereafter. So just be careful. That's why I always recommend when people eat very spicy meals that they add some garlic and some ginger, and maybe some cinnamon or some star anise seed or some, you know, additional herbs or spices, to sort of round out that really strong mouthfeel. And water often helps after the meal. But it's not a good idea to have a sweet dessert after a hot, spicy meal. It's not a great idea. So what about natural salty foods? There are many natural salty foods like olives, for example, you can eat, or sardines, things like that that have got natural salts in them rather than the artificial stuff, all right? Or the man-made salt, we call them. Now that leaves me number five. Now remember we talked about the chalky bar at 3 o'clock? Adrenal fatigue. Now, endocrinologists and some doctors still argue that this condition even exists. But I know darn well it exists because I've worked for a long time with patients with fatigue, particularly adrenal fatigue and thyroid fatigue. So I've seen it. I worked with the world's expert in adrenal fatigue for 10 years, Dr. James Wilson. So this is an area I feel quite competent in. So unfortunately, the adrenal fatigue angle is often misdiagnosed as depression or anxiety, and the patient's sent away with Prozac. Oh, is that microphone on? Let's say it is. And but I think you get the drift that adrenal fatigue is a functional disorder. Well, we can actually measure it through salivary testing of cortisol, and there are physical signs. You can look at some of my other videos on adrenal fatigue, but this is an area I'm going to expand on a lot more in future. So when you get in the fight or flight mode, you start getting all sorts of problems. There are four stages here. We'll just go through them really quickly. So the immediate reaction to stress is to create hormones that help you deal with that stress. So fatigue can be mild at this point, but this is often when people want sugar or sweet things to get them up and going, because they're tired, they're getting a little bit tired now, they're stressed out. We're going into stage two, cortisol starts going up, we're getting increasingly more blood sugar issues, DHEA starts going down. So at this point, you can start feeling a little bit depressed or down or upset about things. These hormones also have a big effect on your mood. All sorts of sleep disruptions can occur. And as you're going into level three or four, it just gets deeper to the point of exhaustion, where you literally can't do much anymore. So I cannot tell you how many people we've had through our clinic with blood sugar disorders and wanting sweet things and wanting, you know, fizzy soda pop drinks and wanting lots of caffeine. I've seen patients drink up to 30 cups of coffee a day with serious adrenal fatigue, 1 to 2 white sugars in each cup. Now you may laugh or think that I'm just speaking porkies here, but I'm not. It's the truth. When you get that tired and that depressed and that anxious, you don't really care what goes in here anymore, as long as it makes you feel a bit good. Stress is so effective at ruining a person's blood sugar and digestive responses. So you've got to ask yourself this question. This is point number 5. Do you have an adrenal problem? Have you been burned out or stressed? Are you eating sugar inappropriately? This is a very serious thing, and this could well be a big issue for many people. And that's the end of this video, otherwise I'm going to just talk too much. So I hope you got something out of those 5 points. Let's just quickly go through them again. You didn't eat enough, or you ate the wrong kind of sugar. You picked up bad habits, number 2. You ate way too much carbs or starchy food and not enough fat or protein, number 3. You ate lots of really spicy or chili foods or hot foods and you wanted a sweet thing to compensate after. And 5, the adrenal fatigue angle. Thanks for tuning in. Greetings, it's Eric Backer again, the naturopath. I hope you enjoyed that video. Remember, go to yeastinfection.org/goodies if you want to download my free resources I've created just for people like you. These are things I used in the clinic for patients and you'll find them very useful. It's the free Candida diet, the cleanse. So it's a good introduction on how to set your program together. There's the ultimate Candida diet shopping list, and there's also the Candida symptom tracker. yeastinfection.org/goodies. Thanks for tuning in and subscribe. Thank you.